Me and my wife opened this group home so we could help these girls like nobody helped me. I had a few people who helped me along the way, but mostly I was left to take care of myself. I wasted a lot of years being bitter and hurting other people who never did nothing to me. I figured this was my chance to make up for it all.
What about you?
What do you mean?
Well, I've told you all my dark secrets. How about you telling me some of yours?
I don't really have any to tell.
Everyone has a story.
Nope.
Well, you're not really here just for a visit, are you?
How did you?
I've been around, Jamie. I'm not stupid.
I guess you're not.
Come on, tell me.
I don't really want to talk about it.
Let me guess. You're pregnant?
God, no. Yesterday, I packed my bags and left home for good.
You ran away?
You sound disappointed.
I'm not gonna lie. I was hoping for something a little more exciting.
I just couldn't stand living there anymore. It was bad enough when my perfect sister's around, but now my mum has this new guy living with us, and everything has just changed.
These girls need help. From the small to the life-changing incidents, they need someone to support them and make them believe they are worthy. But helping these girls is like trying to grow flowers in the desert. And that isn't easy.
Sarge! Ah!
It's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready now, four for the goal, but don't you step on my blue suede shoes. You can do anything, but lay off of my blue suede shoes. You can knock me down, step on my face, slam my name all over the place. Do anything that you want to do.
What are you reading? Get the post! Give me that!
Speedy delivery!
Yes. Here, let me see. Did I get a letter?
Back off, girls. I'll call the names. And if you want one, that'll be your quid.
What? I don't have...
She's joking, Paula.
Yeah, sure I am. And if you don't have a quid, you can fight me for it.
No, thank you.
Hurry up, Tina!
Okay. Bailee.
Thanks.
A big envelope for Paula.
Give me my letter.
I want to look at it. It's from a good girl school. Maybe I should go there.
They wouldn't let you in. They don't take mean people.
I've actually been insulted. Paula's actually insulted me.
Just give Paula her letter, please.
Yeah, hurry. I want to see what I got.
Hey, look at this.
Someone's returned one of Sarge's letters.
Let me see. I wonder who it's from.
If you open it, I'll tell.
If you tell, I'll smash your face in. Don't worry, we won't look at it.
Ugh, I hate him!
Is she alright?
Shelly? Are you alright?
Whoa, what's the matter with her?
Probably her boyfriend again. I mean, no one wants a girlfriend who lives in a group home.
Yeah, he basically said she's ugly and he doesn't want anything to do with her anymore.
She brings it on herself.
Shall we?
Piss off!
Some of these girls have been through so much in their lives. There are always downfalls, some more serious than others. But there are also the good times, and throughout it all, we need to keep the girls grounded.
So, how long have you got without privileges?
A month. It's not that bad. It just means you stay in your room and not talk to anyone.
What's that?
Sarge's letter.
What? It's not yours.
Whoa, you sound like Paula. If you don't want to be a part of it, I'll read it on my own. Dear Emma, thank you for sending me a photo of little Billy. He's growing up so fast.
I hope he grows up to be as handsome as his father. Remember to send a reply back to my other address. If my wife finds out I have a child with you, she'll kill me. It won't be long till we can become a family. Just a few months and I'll leave this place and we can start our lives together.
Away from everyone.
Oh my God.
Sarge has a secret child.
This is the start of a new chapter for the girls.
We're going to be moved and separated.
The difference being, this time, I won't be there to guide them through.